Okay, today we're going to talk about the major solar flares going on. We have these M-class major solar flares happening that are really surprising NASA. We are in solar flare cycle 11. Yes, the sun goes through cycles. So we are going to hit the peak in July of 2025. What's going to happen? Does it affect people? Well, you know, in 1859, the Carrington Event occurred. That was the first time we connected something showing up on the sun's surface with what's going to happen here, and it was way worse than what we've been experiencing. Now, it's going to be actually more of a problem for us than back in 1859. Why? They didn't have computers then. They didn't have cell phones. I'm going to share with you what actually happens if we have the major blast. And this is possible. It's been going on. And let's talk about what it does to you personally. You may be feeling the effects of this. Let's talk about that right now. Welcome to Landria Onkka on YouTube, here to help you break through those fears and live an amazing life. I hope you'll subscribe. I've got some cool stuff coming up because we've got some big events going on here. I hope you've purchased my book, Breakthrough Fear, because I'm talking about exactly what's going on right now in that book, and that is major changes. Everything is energy, and guess what? We create our own reality, and quantum physics supports that if you have a thought, you're actually directly affecting the reality that occurs. In other words, scientists who viewed events changed the events just through their observation. And what they thought about the event changed the results. Yes, this is crazy stuff, right? But that's what we are. And we're starting to recognize how powerful we are and going into what I call the higher frequency. Now, we are walking energy fields, right? All connected. There's no separation between you and I. So what's going on with the sun and how does that affect us? Well, I'm going to give you a little bit of a history here in the Carrington 1859 event when it was discovered that these flashes seen on the sun were then directly affecting Earth. Now, this was a major event, and I'm going to talk about that in a moment, but we're going through a cycle of solar flares that are happening earlier than expected. It was supposed to be next year, and we've had some major M-class flares that have been taking things out. Now, have you been feeling a little weird? Now, they say it doesn't really affect humans, but I think that's ridiculous. If it can take out cell phones and computers, of course it's affecting us, because I just said we're one energy field. So, of course, whatever happens over here is going to affect me on some level. What can it do? High blood pressure. It can screw up your circadian rhythm. And guess what? There is a correlation between solar flares and rheumatoid arthritis. I'm going to go through all of this with you and show you exactly what happened back in 1859 and how crazy some incidents were, and also what's going to happen to us in July of 2025 when we have a major peak of this cycle. Yeah, this is real stuff. We just had some big events about a week ago, and I know some of my friends were saying they didn't feel right. That is real stuff, and it could be directly affected with these solar flares. So, welcome to my channel. I'm Landria Onkka. We're going to get started. We're going to have some fun today because I'm just going to share some things about these solar flares where you don't escape this stuff, right? So let's do a little history lesson right now. The Carrington event was a large solar storm that took place at the beginning of September of 1859. An amateur sky watcher in a small town called Red Hill near London in England observed this. He was blinded by a sudden flash of light, and he described it as a white light flare, and the whole event lasted about 5 minutes. Well, here's the interesting part. It was the following day when amazing things started to happen. It was a coronal mass ejection that Carrington saw. And Earth, the entire planet, experienced an unprecedented geomagnetic storm. Telegraph systems were going haywire.
auroral displays, including in the south. You know, we see aurora borealis. Well, we've been seeing those here in Florida, and rarely is that ever seen except for in the north. It was a direct connection, a solar storm. That's why it's called the Carrington Event, when he put these two things together. So what happened in 1859? Earth fell silent. And they didn't have computers back then, as telegraph communications around the world failed. There were reports of sparks showering from telegraph machines, operators receiving electrical shocks, and papers set ablaze by the sparks. And here's the interesting part. They were still sending some communications, even though they had unplugged the units. Solar energy, right? If the power of the Carrington Event happened today, it would cause an internet apocalypse, sending large numbers of people and businesses offline. Now, that wouldn't be permanent. Now, let's talk about what this means for us coming up. What's going to happen if July 2025 is a big flare? Well, we'd have outages that would decommission everything from cell phones and computers to automobiles and airplanes. Now, why automobiles? Because they became computerized. What automobiles can easily survive this? Older ones that don't have computer systems in them. All right, so think about that. Mine happens to be a 28-year-old two-seater BMW without all the fancy computers on it. So chances are pretty good it's going to survive. But let's talk about what it's going to do to your body. And this could be happening right now because we're having some major flares. Periods of intense solar activity can disrupt the body's circadian rhythm, nervous system, heart rate, and blood pressure, even if it's not visible to the human eye. The British Medical Journal showed a highly significant correlation between periodic solar storms and incidence of rheumatoid arthritis, which is an autoimmune disease. Now, solar storms affect the circadian rhythm in humans, reducing the production of melanin, and increasing levels of the stress hormone cortisol, effects that are more pronounced in patients with coronary heart disease. So in addition to the intensity of the radiation to stress immune systems, there could also be variable clinical expressions of mental illness and these autoimmune disorders. So what's going to happen? You might find out that your sleep patterns are messed up, you're stressed a little bit, you have heart palpitations, your blood pressure is going up. Now, I don't want to plant these ideas in your head. However, I have to say that I noticed some things physically that feel a little different. So we have had an acceleration of these flares in the last year, which was supposed to be happening in 2025. NASA cannot predict these things, but it does go in cycles.
So what do we do when these things happen? There isn't much you can do. It can take out cars, planes, cell phones, computers, yes, automobiles and planes. So you might want to tune in and track these things and find out if maybe you're personally feeling some effects from it. We're going to talk more about some events that are coming up with our planet and our own energy field. I want to talk more about this whole quantum physics thing, because we are actually operating like the sun. Whatever we're putting out is affecting everything out there. And whatever we're believing affects the actual results. Yes, wave and particle. What does that mean? I'm going to talk about that in our next video. You're going to love this because you're going to realize how amazingly powerful you are with that one thought. Yeah, and also those doubts and negative ones you have. Let's be careful with that, because you and I are creating every moment. That means that what you're thinking right now is our future. We're going to talk more about that in the next video. And as always, Digital Explorers, we are creating planet conscious businesses. People are coming on board. We're having a blast. It's a personal journey. It's really finding out, what do I love? What do I want to create? How do we monetize it? You don't have to have any background. Nothing with technology is taught on there. We're just creating planet-conscious businesses based on your passion, purpose and the positive impact we're going to have. What a way to earn money. Also, these are free. This is free inspiration and how to break through fear. I hope you'll subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in the next video when we talk about quantum physics, the power that you hold. You are whole and perfect, strong and powerful, loving, harmonious, and happy. Blessings to you, my friend. Namaste.